Welcome back to the Fuller Fanatics channel. I'm going to speak about budget modding and some non-expensive pieces anyone can feel 100% comfortable practicing different techniques and methods when etching, tumbling, and dyeing scales. The first build I would suggest is the Crkt Pilar, which can be picked up for about 30 bucks. With this 2.4 inch blade, the Pilar definitely has an adequate amount of real estate to practice whatever pattern or techniques you wish. I applied streaks of nail polish along the flat grind as well as the spine, and anywhere I didn't want to etch, including the pivot, lockup, and detent track. While attached to a plastic hook, I submerged the entire blade for about 15 minutes. Then, I immediately gave the blade a baking soda bath to stop the acid's reaction to the steel. I proceeded to wash and clean the blade thoroughly, and this was the outcome. And I took the same approach on the Pilar's frame and pocket clip. With the frame, I actually added a lot of snail trails. This provided a little depth and contrast on the handles, as well as masking future scratches. The backspacer is comprised of who knows, but all I do know, the original spacer literally disintegrated in the acid, possibly 2 minutes in. And with it costing 30 bucks, I wasn't that bent out of shape about it. Per my email request, Crkt sent off a replacement part and everything worked out. And although I can easily deploy this blade with a thumb or finger flick, the action out of the package definitely doesn't come this way. As with all of my non-expensive knives, I open up, clean, polish, and tune to achieve an action I like. But the Pilar, which is about $10 more, does have this action straight from the factory. This larger version actually has a flipper tab, and the show side is a black G10. This Pilar is actually running on bearings, and I'm really mentioning all of this to say, if you etch this model, make sure to cover the bearings race and entire pivot area, as well as the tang / lockup area. If you bypass this step, the action will be drastically affected, in a bad way, so just take the time and do it. If you want to keep your edge, paint it as well, and it will stay. Otherwise, being the thinnest part of the blade, it goes first. And if you plan on a tumbled finish, the protection of the blade's edge can be skipped because most mediums used are going to knock your edge off regardless of the paint. On this particular etch, I left the blade submerged for 25 minutes or so. I wanted the etch deep and dark so I could try something different. A tumble I dubbed the Bitcoin finish. I literally took a handful of old hex bits and 3 times the amount in pocket change. Then I sprayed a bit of WD-40 into the container and shook it up by hand. After this step, I added a texture color effect by taking a couple of light passes with a bronze wire wheel Dremel attachment. I took the same formula to the aluminum lock side, only difference being I used paint to stop the etch on the inside of the tip down pocket clip area. And this is because, simply, it resembled a skull to me, so I just made it stand out a bit more. And again, another moment and choice I made purely because if it didn't work out, I wouldn't be kicking myself about it. But it honestly worked out great. On the lock bar, as you can clearly see, I dropped paint into the detent drain as well as the other side, including the entire detent ball and lockup area. This is all in an attempt to prevent any change in the action. And if you look closely, you may catch little details such as the color left behind by the pennies used in the tumble, or the contrasting spine, thumb hole, and finger choil, which I covered after the etch but prior to the tumble, leaving both areas sporting a flat rugged look that is actually a bit more grippy than the brush finish areas, which I prefer for purchase during deployments or thumb placement grip, especially while using this amazing finger choil. As for the pocket clip, I etched it very lightly, not enough to remove the Crkt branding, and this being the only billboarding I let remain, and in a much fainter text than the factory etching. In addition, I lightly buffed out just the edge of the clip, adding a break from the etched background with the pop of a glowing outline. To keep the theme going, I also etched the flipper tab and added the wire finish to both sides, again leaving the gem side etched only. This brings me to the final Crkt budget mod, the Minimalist Boy with Gears. This fixed blade can be picked up for about 20 bucks. Only offered in a bright lime green or bright tone jade color, I wanted to first remove the gears, knowing I was going to do a writ dye job on the handles and the lime green gear pattern wouldn't match. You can actually boil the blade and this will all be quickly removed. After this step, I took the blade to the acid dip, leaving it for quite some time. I wanted the etching on the spine to stop at the jimping's end, leaving the steel in the handle satin finish. This is just a straight etch job with no tumble, and I'm going to again try something different to find out what the outcome will be. As for the handles, I just didn't like the color, so with trying to bring the color back to the other minimalists, which appears to me as a lush green turquoise color, therefore I used a blue and gray mix, and I also dyed the sheath included with the knife. These handles and sheath are not G10, GFN, or FRN, yet they are comprised of polypropylene, and this will take much longer in the boil for the dye to adhere. I ran the handles and sheath submerged in a boiling dye for about 40 minutes, and any light color G10 would almost be black by this point. The reason for this material use, I believe, is the boy minimalist with gears and sheath are both glow in the dark. And even though I asked the sales rep, he told me, nope, it's just that ugly color. One day recently, it was sitting in the sunlight, just a random moment in my windowsill, and I took it into my garage, which is pitch black. And I was like, wait, what the hell is this? At first I thought the dye may have been glow in the dark, but I looked up the vids on the gear minimalist, and it's definitely glow in the dark. And even after the color work, she still glows bright as ever. So this sums up my budget mods, but I'm sharing this because these were my start. And I will always look back and laugh at the thought. There was once a time I was actually nervous about doing this to a knife. Please rate, share, comment down below, and definitely, if you respect the Fuller Fanatic handle, subscribe to the Fuller Fanatic channel. And with that, I'll be signing off. Until next time, the Fuller Fanatic.